Hey guys and girls, welcome to another episode in Forza Horizon 3. Now today's episode is going to be how to ruin a classic muscle car. That's right, we're going to completely ruin a classic muscle car. Already I can hear people going, no, why? Why would you do that, you idiot? Why? Well, because we can. That's the simple thing, because we can. What we're going to do is we are going to go and find ourselves a classic muscle car that we already own, so I don't have to spend money on it. So, let's see, what car do I want to ruin, destroy, completely screw up, and make absolutely horrible? One classic, Impala Supersport? Okay, we might come back to the Impala Supersport. Charger RT? Yeah, I could offend a lot of people by modifying that thing. Nah, I like the Charger too much to ruin it. Let's see, what else we got? Mustang? Maybe. Nah. Crown Vic? Nah. SVT Cobra? Nah. Nah. That's already ruined, so we're not going to ruin that. That Mustang 2 is my drag car, which pulls 19s on the airport strip, so I'm not ruining that because it's already ruined. It's specifically built just for drag races, that's it. It doesn't do anything else, it just does drag races. I think the Impala Supersport is so far our best bet for ruining a classic muscle car. So, let's keep going. Myers Manx, nope. Nope. There's no muscle this far down. I don't have to ruin that. It already is. It's all-wheel drive. And these two are my favorite muscle cars of all time, so I'm not going to mess around with these. This lot. Not going to happen. So, let's go back and get that Impala Supersports, and we'll ruin it. Now, how do you mean ruin it? Well, the way I mean ruin it is basically make it absolutely horrible to drive, and give it things that muscle cars don't have. Like, when was the last time you heard of an all-wheel drive muscle car? Yeah, exactly. Pointless and pathetic. So, let's do this. Let's get in. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to add some really, really crappy rims. Like, we're going to make this thing look crap. We're going to take a classic vehicle and basically ruin it completely. I'm going to get much satisfaction in doing this. At the moment, as you can see, big, lumpy, carby 426 V8. Look, it's even set up for twin air intake. Look at that. The induction noise on this thing must be awesome. But treasure that while you can, because this thing is gonna get ruined. Okay, so let's go ruin this thing. First things first. Ooh, we got upgrades. Okay. No, we're not gonna go that far. That's a street rod. That looks too good. So we won't be doing that. Let's go custom. First thing we're going to do is we're going to swap the engine out. Okay. So we're going to go for a V10. Why not? Because we can. And just for giggles, we're going to twin turbo it. And that's right. We've got to do a platform swap. That's right. All-wheel drive, no worries. What else are we going to do? We're going to upgrade the transmission. Not much we can do here. We only get one option of a clutch. Okay, just make sure. Yeah, only one option for the clutch. Now it needs to stop. So we definitely need some brakes. Let's get it into the weeds, yep. Actually, if I was to ruin this, I'd go up. Yes, that's right. I'll turn it into an absolute ridiculous looking thing with the worst rims humanly possible. whacking on a diet. So now not only have we managed to offend the classic car fraternity by turning this thing into a raised V10 twin turbo. Some people are saying, yeah, but all you've done is gotten a Viper engine and twin turboed it. Yeah, no. No, this doesn't have a Viper engine. This has got the power plant out of a Gallardo. I am really offending everybody today. Why? Because I can. Simple. I can offend anyone I want. It's Forza. And then we're going to stick this thing into a race and just watch it fall all over the road. Right, that's that done. Now, let's go into the aero and completely ruin it. Yep, front chin spoiler. Yep, let's get that wing happening. Let's get that bonnet happening. There we go. Now for the rims. What are the chintziest, horrible, most horrible looking rims I can think of? Wow. I got a choice of a rally combo because I put the rally suspension on it. Interesting. Gonna go the race tires. Let's bag those tires out as wide as they can go. A lot wider. Cool. Let's get them as large as they can go. Oh yeah, now we're rolling on what? 22s? 25? What? 19s, okay. Cool. Okay, let's change those rims out. Let's get something really tacky. See, that to me doesn't look too bad. All that. So they're not tacky enough. Yes, now we're getting into the horrible stuff. Make it real bad looking. Oh, I can't go past them. They have to be the rims. They have to be. They just look so bad. I'm about to spend $100,000 ruining this vehicle. Why? Because I'm nuts. Alright, so we're going to go stick this thing into a race. Now, oh, paint job. Paint job, yeah. Forgot about that. We have to get a tacky looking paint job. So let's go see. Now, I apologize if you are the creator of the paint design that I'm about to use and I call it tacky. But, yeah. Maybe I should do my own tacky paint job, but I really don't have the time on this video to go doing that. I mean, it's taken 8 minutes just for us to get this far. Come on. Come on. Load it up. Hurry up. If you crash the internet on me, I won't be happy. That's what happens when you operate on wireless internet. Oh, there we go. Okay. So that's a thing. Okay, let's try this again. I'll just make my own tacky paint job. Paint the car. Special colors. Yes. Oh, no, even the white version. Oh, how about we just make it camo? Oh, hang on. What about that? Does that look bad? Oh, that looks horrible. Camouflage doesn't look good on anything other than military vehicle. So, yeah, that would quite successfully ruin the vehicle for us. Let's go back. Let's go in here. Metal flake. Let's change the hue on it. Alright, let's keep going here. If I could get salmon pink, I'd be happy. Okay, let's go here. Let's change this. Oh! Metallic poo brown. Nice. Yeah, we'll go with that. That looks good to me. Oh, I just hit the wrong button. Oh. Yeah, we'll just go with that. That looks work bad enough. Then we're going to whack it into a race and see how we go. I have no idea how this is going to sound. I've got no idea how it's going to drive. I'm not even going to tune it. I'm just going to go straight into Forza and we'll see how we go. Untuned, untested, straight in.
Hey, Master Chief. There's a driver who's got a bit of a following.
Whoa.
It might be worth bringing them into your lineup.
Tell you what, slides. Old girl moves, that's for sure. The suspension. Oh, the sprint. Let's do the sprint instead. The sprint's around the corner. That'll be quicker for us, I think. Instead of doing a lap race. Oh, this is such a boat of a thing to drive. Alright, here we go. Put it into a sprint race and let's just see how we go. Untested, completely untested. Alright. So, hopefully I've managed to offend several people with this video. Controversy is the key to success. Why be the same as everyone else? Be different. Be different. Live on the edge. So I've probably offended, let's see, the classic Hot Rod fraternity, the Rally fraternity, and I think even the off-road fraternity by making a hot rod with rally suspension and all drive. Here we go. Oh, looks like we got some stiff competition in this race. I'm sorry guys, but that is the worst I can make a car. If you've got suggestions on how I can make it worse, post them down in the comment section below. No, I'm not V12 swapping it because I think the V12 sound gets boring after a while. That's a trick. This is a land barge. Ow. Some of you were like, well, use the brakes, stop hitting the trees. Yeah, it doesn't stop very well. Even with carbon ceramic brakes, this thing has a lot of body roll and doesn't want to steer. That's what I mean, I ruined it. Got some get up and go. Oh no, you don't. No pit maneuvers today, sweetheart. Bye bye. I'm gonna ruin it by coming down here too fast, aren't I? Oh, come on, turn. Sharp corners are not this thing's friend. I think this V10 sounds more like it came out of like an Audi R8 than a Viper. Oh, this is very floaty. Well, there's 306 k's an hour out of it. And across the line. There you go, guys and girls. We managed to come first. So, in our completely ruined Chevy Impala, we managed to come first up against some pretty stiff opposition. Most of them are rated, you know, maybe 1 point below us or something like that. So the Bone Shaker, the Twin Mills, seem to kick their butts pretty good. But anyway, guys and girls, there you go. That is how you ruin a classic. Alrighty, don't worry, guys and girls. I will be basically stripping most of the parts out of this thing and probably selling it. Until next time, guys and girls, I will say bye. And look at the brake calipers hardly even fit over the rims. Well, the rims barely fit over the brake calipers. Yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Yeah, but there you go. That's how you ruin a classic. Until next time, guys and girls, I will say bye for now.